and welcome to Stockholm, the fifth capital city on my tour here. I am glad that I can understand at least a few more words here. Third conference. It is in this beautiful building, ISBE, International Society for Behavioral Ecology. It's gonna be lots of bird talks and mammal talks. I'm still excited about the behavior.
From the Department of Zoology, we'd like to thank you for coming and welcome you to Stockholm. We know for a lot of you it was a bit of a challenge to get here, and we are very excited to see you.
Checking out the venue. That's funny. First proper day of the conference, and I will give my talk in the afternoon. Which means that in the morning I have missed the plenary talk. At least I could get my slides completely finished for the updated version of my talk, because I always want to improve it a little bit and add a little more data. And so that's what I did, and I'm somewhat happy with it. And now it's about enjoying the rest of the presentations of the morning. I just uploaded my slides to the system, so, you know, from a stick to a person who put it on the computer so that everything is ready and there are no technical difficulties like we had in the last conference. So this is normal here. And yeah, this is the room where I will be giving my presentation, and I'm just checking it out. It's really good to know what it looks like when you're going through the slides and imagining presenting it to the audience, that you like know where to point. I will try to record myself giving the presentation as well. First symposium talk.
This has been measured in holding and consuming food. And this ranges between 80 to 100%, but I suspect it's even higher because some of these are very small sample sizes.
Placement task, I re-hide the food behind another barrier. The alligators don't move that much, so sometimes it seems like the video stopped it. They didn't. But again, I let the videos run for you, but because time constraints, I directly tell you, spoiler alert, all our species have object permanence, they perform above chance in these tasks. The alligator just failed. So she touched the barrier where there's food behind. She has a mesh barrier, the non is a transparent barrier, both species did both. And the Nandu is about to pass, she goes around the transparent barrier, the alligator is still at it. They have probably good associative learning skills, and that probably varied in flexibility.
Lunch break, practicing my talk some more.
Is that males have contrasting spectral slopes to stand out, whereas the females have similar spectral slopes to their environment to blend in.
In the first climate round, here you see the euros spent on climate change mitigation per rich, pink, and per poor, clear, blue.
That's enough exercise for the day.
Välkommen till mina områden.
So, the end of the first day, or first day proper, and my talk went well. Again, got cool questions, and people approached me afterwards saying how nice it is. Yeah, so I guess it's time to tell you a little bit about the organization of such a conference. So, in Helsinki, we had 14 simultaneous sessions, and one session was at least then 2 hours of talks that have a similar kind of theme. So, for me today, it was a collective movement behavior, so that was very fitting. And then you have about 12 minutes of talks with 3 minutes of questions afterwards, and some people are better with keeping their 12 minutes than others, and I have also taken up 13 minutes this time again. Anyway, this conference is, it's very nice because you have 5 minutes of being able to change the room. So usually people either say, okay, I'm gonna just sit in one symposium and listen to all the talks, but now in this conference it's very easy to switch the room, so you have in the schedule just marked the talks that you want to go to, and then you hop from one to another. And then every 2 hours or so after the sessions of these symposia, you have breaks, so a coffee break in the morning, lunch break, and then another coffee break in the afternoon, where you mingle and you talk to old friends or make new ones with some free coffee and tea, though usually the tea selection is pretty poor. So I'm just drinking milk, oat milk, with sweetener, which is also fine because I don't do caffeine regularly anyway. Yeah, and then it's dinner where you might join other people to have dinner somewhere in town, which I did not do at all in Helsinki. Oh, and in the middle of a 5-day conference, there is usually just a half day with some activities to also socialize, and that's something organized or semi-organized. Maybe I will actually join the soccer tournament or like doing tours around town. But I'm very pleased with the location, very well organized. What I especially like is that everything is perfectly timed, so everything is synchronous, and there is a bird call being played through the speakers after 12 minutes when the time is over, that everything runs smoothly. Quite the maze. It's Sunday and there are like a fifth of the people on the street. Everything is quiet, closed. Even the escalators are closed. For us though, it's just a normal day. In the middle of the conference with half a day to relax a little bit in the evening or afternoon. Beautiful day to spend inside.
The first time that it has ever been in this position. Okay, so we've tried several dozen.
Do we have any questions?
Pattern, color, and so it's a complex display, much like those birds of paradise. In contrast to the birds of paradise, these males are really nervous because 20 to 30% of these interactions end up with the female attacking the male and sometimes eating him, right? So he's really dancing for his life right here. High stakes signaling. To stop this before the naughty bits happen.
Special scale. But this goes really weird for the kestrel. This is brand new stuff that the frog's head is glowing at distance too. Absolutely glowing. That's caused by simultaneous contrast.
This is not very common behavior, but at least a couple of bees were doing this. So God opened the doors at the same time and the bees were just running to the other side, and whenever they touch the door at the same time, we just let them in. As you can see, first bee quite often turned around from the door because the other bee wasn't there.
And that was pretty much the last day. Now all that is left is to explore the Skansen, the oldest open-air museum in the world. And after an hour or so of doing that, starting the gala dinner with a smorgasbord. Morning, I'm on my way to my next flight to Copenhagen for some holidays finally. I'm tired and exhausted. I'm glad that I did not drink too much alcohol yesterday. Yeah.